right, Doc, thanks very much. As we continue with our Wednesday night rivalry doubleheader, the teams that have met in the Western Conference Finals each of the last 2 years, and they've won the last two Stanley Cups, the LA Kings, the defending champions, playing host to the Chicago Blackhawks, as we take a look at our starting goalies presented by Honda, and a couple of guys that are probably looking to find their A game compared to what they were showing heading into the All-Star break. Corey Crawford, who was an All-Star, you see his numbers on the season. And down at the other end, it is Jonathan Quick. He really struggled in the last 7 games or so before the All-Star break. His last win coming on January the 1st. Dave Strader joined by Eddie Olczyk in the broadcast booth. Brian Engblom is our man inside the glass. And Edzo, I would expect a very spirited matchup between these two, their second meeting of the season.
Yeah, no doubt, Strades. And I think for the Los Angeles Kings, the playoffs start right now, looking to get into the top 8 spots in the Western Conference.
They are 3 points out of a playoff spot as we begin this game. Chicago is in a battle in the Central Division, chasing Nashville, who won last night, and trying to contend with St. Louis and Winnipeg for second place, at least in the Central, as you take a look at Daryl Sutter. Heard what Edzo said a few moments ago. The playoffs start now for the LA Kings, 3 points out. Now here is Patrick Sharp, sends it across. Quickland, top of the circle, take rebound, score! Patrick Kane makes it 1-0, 1:58 in.
Well, what a great play by Patrick Sharp to get the puck back to the point. But this puck is blocked by Braden McNabb. It goes off his left hand. And when you're hot, it goes right to the fourth leading scorer in the entire National Hockey League. It goes right to the stick of Patrick Kane.
Yeah, that's far from the prime scoring area, but you do see more and more goals scored off to the side of the net. Patrick Kane's got radar this year. He is on top of his game offensively. And you're right, a goal scorer's goal. That one came right to him. He just had to put it in from a bad angle.
And when you're going well, the puck finds you in the offensive zone, whether you want it or not. And there, Getzis has a stick in a perfect position there. Denies a chance from Drew Doughty going through the middle of the ice. But a bad break for the LA Kings. McNabb does the right thing. He gets in that shooting lane. He goes right off his left hand. He was right to Kane.
Yeah, he was the only one in the shooting area, which is kind of unusual. That was the second good shot, because Seabrook had a really good one-timer from the point as well, and there wasn't much traffic between him and the net.
Doughty's shot is turned aside by the middle of the ice to Foley. Played well there by Oduya. Now Dwight King gets to it, hands it out to Toffoli, to the front, quick shot, and saved by Crawford. And where's it end up? Crawford was trying to find it. It finally comes into the near faceoff circle.
Yeah, went off his chest, came right back into the scrum there, but the Hawks are able to get to it first.
Big shift there from Tyler Toffoli. Won the physical battle, then got the puck to the right guy, Jeff Carter, in front. And Crawford's made a couple of huge saves. There's been a couple of rebounds at either end. So I'm sure both coaches will be telling their players get second and third chance opportunities. But there's the power move from Toffoli, Carter all by himself, and Crawford with a big time stop.
Yeah, Nordstrom comes in late here, but Johnny Oduya's in kind of a funny position there. He's off to the corner of the net, but he never looked in front. So Nordstrom came back, number 42, and tried to get the Carter, but it was that guy who made the difference on the play, no doubt.
Carter with no goals in the last 7 games.
So if you're circling like that, they're going to be able to pass that puck by you, and the Blackhawks were able to cash in.
That's very unusual for the Kings, too.
Turnover. Williams cuts in, save. Loose puck. Crawford down. The Hawks get to it first in the blue paint, and they send it all the way back down inside the LA line.
Another big rebound there, coming right back into the scoring area. Great power move there from Williams, and a better stop from Corey Crawford with that left pad.
Now Regier lays it ahead into the Chicago zone. Picked up by Oduya, pressured by Williams. Oduya ahead for Richards off of his stick and picked up by the goal scorer Kane. Beats it on the far side. A chance here for Sharp is blocked. And Regier able to push it back out to center ice.
Nice block by Martinez.
Carter with speed across the line. Loses it, gets it back, and slides it wide. Now McNabb hands it off. Here's Carter. Carter with a shot. He scores!
Second A-plus chance of this first period for Jeff Carter, and he cashes in on the short side. McNabb keeps his puck alive, As Carter's skating away from Corey Crawford, he goes upstairs, no chance for the Hawk goaltender.
That's a real confusing play for the defense, that's true, because Carter comes out from behind the net and he's going the wrong way. And then he turns around and throws one top shelf. It freezes all the defenders of Chicago. There's time and room, and what a shot by Carter.
An important response to be sure for the LA to the front. McNabb, who got an assist along with Toffoli on the Carter goal. Nolan, nice pass here for Lewis, cutting in! And a save made by Crawford with Duncan Keith doing all he could to defend the play. Now Nolan again to the corner. Shore sends it to the far side. Keith able to get it to Shaw.
Boom! Huge hit. Nolan on Shaw right in front of Brian there. Wow.
Bob down to Taves in the corner. He'll go back to the line for Duncan Keith. Hands it back to Taves. Taves for Kane, quickly across. Comes all the way out to Keith. Sends it back down to number 88. Out to the middle of the ice, Keith to the far side. Sharp. Back for Keith, hammers one here. Saved by Quick. And boy, it gets nasty in a hurry in front of the LA goal.
Boy, the Kings did a really good job of keeping the Blackhawks to the outside, and then eventually the puck got to the middle of the ice. Duncan Keith with the shot and a terrific save from Jonathan Quick, with Andrew Shaw standing right in front of the net. No rebound given up, and that's the key. But that just that little lane there, Quick was able to see it in between two King forwards, and Shaw standing right off to the right side, and Quick was able to absorb it.
That puck had eyes going through all those bodies, and Robin Regier, who's a top customer, has got to get in the face of Andrew Shaw, which is exactly what he did. Shaw gives away a lot of size there, but he said earlier in the year, if I'm going to score more, when he was really struggling, he said, I've got to get to the front of the net. That's my game.
Kings try to clear, but Duncan Keith will hold it in. Hands it back to Kane. Now Taves back to Keith. Nice, short, crisp passes on this power play. Across on the far side, Sharp scores! Patrick Sharp on the power play. And Chicago has regained the one-goal advantage.
Tremendous passing here by the two Patricks. Sharp plays the point, and he sneaks down that left-wing side because he's the right-hand shot. Kane at the top of your screen. Watch him find the seam. Duncan Keith sets it up for him, makes a nice little pass down past the circle. And I know that in the past, the goaltender said, I'd like to be able to track those Jonathan Quick, but he couldn't get over in time, Eddie.
Boy, not much room there to move that puck from one side of the ice to the other. And the one thing that world-class players do is they draw attention. And when you overcommit or you give them just a seam, the pass will be right by you and no hesitation. From Patrick Sharp.
Here come the Hawks again. Smith across for Kruger. Just broken up in the last second, but recovered by Smith. Able to elude a couple.
Goal scorer's stick.
Now it comes to Carter. Hangs onto it. Tried to chip it out to the line. Taves got in the way of that, but it comes to Carter again with a shot. He scores! Oh, he doesn't need a lot of room. He found some there over the glove side shoulder of Corey Crawford, and on the power play, the Kings have tied the game.
Carter's first goal of the game, he went high, stick side on Corey Crawford, and you talk about a release, all in one motion, little push and pull with those hands, pull it in and then just let it go, no chance for Crawford.
Well, it was a mix-up of communication here. Look at Chicago playing man-on-man there. Taves thought he had Oduya coming in behind him for support, but Oduya went to Kopitar and played a man-on-man with him, assuming that Taves had Carter coming off the wall. He didn't. Carter spins off the wall and goes top shelf.
Yeah, over-aggressiveness there from Johnny Oduya. And then Jeff Carter, I think his eyes just lit up there, Brian, when all of a sudden he had that lane to take the puck right to the net, and he wasn't thinking about passing. He was letting it go, and you talk about release. That's as good as any player in the entire National Hockey League, Jeff Carter, letting that puck go.
And an icing against the Kings will bring it back into the LA zone. Kopitar and Gabrick on the assist.
But take a look here. See top of your screen. See Johnny Oduya? He went to number 11, Kopitar. He actually didn't even have him. But Taves, on a good move by Carter, good escape move by Carter, doubled back and then just took it right back through the middle of there, and both Taves and Oduya out of position.
Hey, Brian, you played defense. Like, was Oduya thinking that?
2-2 is our score. Each team has a goal at even strength and a power play. Here comes a short-handed chance for the hat trick. Carter, saved by Crawford. Carter again. Trying to sneak one in on the short side. Already has two goals, and he almost had the hat trick here. When we come back, we will hear from Chicago head coach Joel Quenneville in this 2-2 game on Wednesday Night Rivalry presented by Coors Light. Jordan Nolan tries to get it out to the point, but it's taken away by Teravainen. He hits the LA zone. Picked up now by Shaw. Looks at his goal! Andrew Shaw from Teravainen in Chicago for the third time tonight has a one-goal lead.
Well, after some real good work by the fourth line of the LA Kings, Jordan Nolan turns the puck over. He gets pressured by Shaw, the eventual goal scorer, and Teuvo Teravainen. Teravainen gets his puck, moves it to Shaw, and a quick little wrister goes short side high on Jonathan Quick.
Teravainen really good with the puck, and he skates right into the middle of the two defensemen and draws them really both to him. Somehow gets the puck over to Shaw. Boy, we've seen some great wrist shots in this game, right up under the bar and right inside the goalpost, and that was won by Shaw.
That you'd like it
in July,
yeah. You know, to be ready to come back. And now here's a chance for Brown, cutting it with a backhand, and a save made by Crawford. Reacted very quickly with that stick hand.
And Martinez was behind him, but the pass was behind him too.
Now King closing in, sends it toward Crawford. He had to fight that one off as it deflected it toward him. Saad now, look out. He had Regier bearing down on him. Now it comes to Dwight King. Drops it back. A chance here to Bailey. He scores! That's why they wanted number 73 back in the lineup. And he delivers to make it 3-3.
Well, I don't believe Robin Regier is going to get an assist on this goal. He made the play. Brandon Saad had the puck. And it's kept in right there by the eventual goal scorer, Tyler Toffoli. Great play all around, and what a pass from Dwight King. Carter to King to Toffoli. Threes are wild here in the third.
Saad was startled. I could see it across the ice. He didn't think that Regier was going to come down that quickly and couldn't make the play. Tyler Toffoli was covering up for Regier, which is what he's supposed to do when a defenseman pinches down. That put him in perfect third man high position to come in late on the play, and that's the result. He waits, gets in the slot, gets that one-touch pass from King, and what a shot again, right up under the bar. Great goal scored here in this game tonight.
You see Crawford there, he's looking at the official there, wondering if there was any interference by Jeff Carter, I believe, standing in front of the net. But the quick release, not the big slap shot. Beautiful play all the way around. Good defense, as Brian made the point. Good defense leads to an offensive opportunity. And what a backhand pass by King to Toffoli. And welcome back to the lineup, Tyler Toffoli.
Time. Ooh, that was nasty.
Dowdy and Gruber now. Dortch have got it to the front. Loose puck. Quick looking for it. Trying to find it. And finally it's picked up by Muzzin. What a mad scramble in front of the LA net.
Duncan Keith came in from his blue line position and got an unbelievable chance. And with Jonathan Quick doing the splits, he made the stop.
Now Quick steers it to the far side. Toffoli nearly lost it, gets it back. Now it bounces to the side of the LA goal, and Quick has no choice but to cover up for a faceoff.
Well, here Drew Doughty interferes with Marcus Kruger, and then the puck will find its way to the front of the net. Joakim Nordstrom throws it to the front, and there's Duncan Keith. Two white is right in front of the net. Ben Smith is there, and what a stop by Jonathan Quick.
That was a nasty ball into that inboards there by Doughty. And that created the confusion there from the standpoint of the LA Kings. They had to scramble to get back in control, and that gave up the scoring chance. And Quick had to make a big save line.
LA with a face-off win. Regier for Dwight King, who made the terrific pass on the goal by Toffoli. Carter deflected in wide of the Chicago goal. Carter battling with Jalmers, and it comes to Dwight King. And now around and out of play.
Little change of defensive pairs here for Joel Quenneville. Loading up Duncan Keith and Nicholas Hjalmarsson on one set of defensive pairs. There's the opportunity, Carter to King. And there we went through a stretch here where the Blackhawks did an unbelievable job in the middle of the ice. Brian made the point early in the period where the Blackhawks really shut down the LA Kings. But now here the last, what would you say, Brian, last 4 minutes or so, LA's really kind of found their game and they had good support. That last entry there was a great pass from King through the middle of the ice to Carter to be able to get that puck into the zone.
They get it in deep and they keep it.
Shot score! See if it was deflected out of the way, but LA for the first time tonight has the lead.
I'm pretty sure this is deflected. I think it might be Kopitar.
Face-off win. Kopitar beats Jonathan Toews. It's either Brown or Hjalmarsson that it deflects off of, and Brian was bang on saying the puck was deflected.
Yeah, I think it might be both. Hjalmarsson definitely touches that one, and I'm not sure if Dustin Brown does too. Hjalmarsson deep left. Off of Hjalmarsson's for sure. No chance there for Corey Crawford, who was screened again by Brown on that play too.
And think about it. We talked about Jonathan Toews being up in that 70 percentile and winning faceoffs tonight. Kopitar wins one, and the puck ends up in the back of the net.
Regier sends it along. Martinez now is sent back to the side of the net. King dumps it to the far corner. Downing bump there by Toews. Hosen and Regier in on the scrum now. Regier goes down, jumps back up. The puck comes free. Duncan Keith. Getting some help there from Kane. Kane turns, hands it back to the corner now for Toews. Behind the net it goes for Hossa. Hossa the wraparound stop by Quick. Blue puck in the blue paint. It's covered up by Quick and the official right there saying no goal. We've got a faceoff in the LA zone.
Should be a timeout coming here for Joel Quenneville and the Blackhawks, but Marian Hossa gets his puck in behind the net, and he has a lot of room here to walk to the front of the net, but he tries to wrap it around. Watch this. Hossa could go, keep going another 2 or 3 feet there, and then Jonathan Toews tries to shoot this off the backside of Jonathan Quick into the back of the net.
Through the crease twice, once on the wraparound and once on the shot coming back off the post.
Wow.
Toews was on such a severe angle, and because he's the left shot on that left wing, doesn't have that good look at the net. It's incredible that he even got it off the goal post just trying to get back in there, and then Quick was able to sit on it.
Well, as you pointed out, Enzo, a timeout has been called by Chicago, and I didn't realize on the live look that this puck right there hit the goal post.
I don't know how that could hit the post with the angle that Brian was talking about where Jonathan Toews was. He was at the, he was at the goal line. It just found its way to the front of the net. There you see assistant coach Kevin Dineen with the dry erase board pointing out the faceoff play that they want to run. And the reminders on both sides for Daryl Sutter and the Kings and for Joel Quenneville and the Blackhawks is what do you do if you win the faceoff and what do you do if you lose it? And to this point right now, the difference in the game is a lost faceoff by the man in white and the one faceoff by the man in black. And the Kings have a one-goal lead here with under a minute left to go.
They tie the faceoff, but the pucks come up with the puck. Keith, Kane, along for Toews, Regier, hard on him, out to Duncan Keith with a shot. Not sure what that hit on the way in toward Quick, but it bounced to the boards.
They went off his glove.
Here is Kane again now. Patrick Kane looking. Half a minute remaining here in the third period. Duncan Keith looking for a shooting or passing lane. Goes to Sharp. Wraps it along the inboard. Doughty gets to it. Tries to clear. It's on the stick of Kopitar. And Dwight King plays it off the boards. And Patrick Sharp had gone back to the bench to get another stick. And we're down to 15 seconds remaining. Chicago had to go all the way back. They still don't have control. A stretch pass here. Nice redirect. Hossa cutting in. Saved by Quick. And the puck is cleared off the board and down the ice. And L.A. is going to win this with a third period comeback by a final score of 4-3. Now, Brian, you said it separates the men from the boys with how you defend. I think it also shows the mental toughness of this defending Stanley Cup championship team, L.A., with everything they've been through, to be behind and come back and find a way to win this game.
Absolutely. You saw that so many times last year in the playoffs. Incredible will, and they showed it again here tonight.
Finding a way, and that's what Daryl Sutter said. He felt, he told us this morning, he felt his team was close, and it's just finding a way to win some of these games with the battle below the goal line. The shot for Duncan Keith, and as Brian mentioned, off the glove of Jonathan Quick, and then a great set play there. Kane to Taves to Hossa, big rebound, and then the hard play by Drew Doughty, who's never left the ice the last 5 or 6 minutes of this third period. A huge win for the LA Kings.
For Brian Engblom inside the glass, my partner in the booth here, Eddie Olczyk, I'm Dave Strader saying, thanks for joining us here tonight. But more coming your way. Wednesday night rivalry presented by Coors Light. The final score here, LA 4, Chicago 3. Stay tuned for NHL overtime from Super Bowl Central in Arizona right after these messages.